Whenever you participate in a race in Assetto Corsa competition, you want to finish it as high up in the grid as possible. Ideally, even on the podium. To achieve this, you of course want to pick the right car. This isn't exactly an easy task though, since there are really no helpful stats displayed in the game. Now, if I think back to the good old days, where games like Need for Speed, for example, were massively popular, you always had the choice between one of three characteristics. A good acceleration, good handling, or good top speed. But you always had to pick one of those. You couldn't have all three at the same time. That's also somewhat true for Assetto Corsa Competition or sim racing games in general. Except the cars in these games are a lot more balanced. And there is no nitro injection, which makes for unrealistic accelerations. To come back to sim racing, or rather Assetto Corsa Competition, we are trying to build these stats on our own. So our goal for this video is to find out which car has the highest potential top speed in Assetto Corsa Competition. Now, if you happen to watch my videos once in a while, you might remotely remember that I already did such an experiment for the 2018 cars. But let's be honest, after I released this video, some of you mentioned in the comments that my techniques applied in this experiment had a few flaws. The shifting was done automatically by the AI, which meant that it sometimes shifted too early and for some cars it shifted too late, which really wasn't ideal. The testing was also done by placing a stationary car at the very beginning of a straight and basically accelerating down the straight from a standstill, which meant that in an area from about 0 to 120 km per hour the traction control would likely interfere and therefore manipulate the end results a bit. So after a bit of research and testing, which is nicely concluded in my last video, where I determined for all of the 2019 cars when it's best to shift, and a bit of, let's call it creative thinking, I came up with this solution. I'm going to conduct my experiments when the cars are already moving instead of a standstill. Now, this massive breakthrough should allow me to get much more precise results. With those two main problems out of the way, there's nothing more that prevents us from sending our cars down the main straight in Paul Ricard. So here's how we're gonna do it. Firstly, we are going to approach this corner at about 150 km per hour. After we've hit the apex, we are going full throttle down the straight, and the moment we leave the track, the top speed is noted. This method should completely eliminate the traction control interference under low speed acceleration, since 150 km per hour isn't really low speed, and no reason at all for the traction control to interfere. Oh yeah, and just as a clarification, all experiments were conducted with an appropriate setup. This means that all aerodynamic elements, like the rear wing, the diffuser and the brake ducts, were set to the lowest settings, while the engine map was on its highest. As there really isn't anything left to say or rather explain about this experiment, and there is just one thing missing, which happens to be the end results, I just wanted to seize this opportunity to thank each and every one of you guys for providing feedback, or rather constructive criticism, which helps me, as it is the case with this video, to sometimes rethink the methods applied in my experiments and therefore also improving the quality of my end results, which I get from my experiments. Also, we reached just about 100 subscribers, which is nice. But anyways, I am now going to present to you the main reason why you probably clicked this video, the results, in a nice graph. So yeah, this is basically it for this short video. If you happen to enjoy this video or get something useful out of it, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I will catch you in the next one. Cheers!